going to record. So there's a couple different ways we can do this. And I'm going to kind of go based on what you guys want to do. When I run an action hour, typically I talk, give ideas while we're running the action hour. But a lot of you know how to do, A lot of you really want to, or know how to work the business already. You know how to do action hours. You do them all the time. You've been on action hours with me before. So do you guys feel, because sometimes when you're a seasoned coach and you come on, Rob, Tabitha says you need a seltzer. No, he says. When you're a seasoned coach and you come on here and then the person leading the call is talking a lot, it's almost like you have your own agenda, you have your own rhythm, you know what you want to do for your work. So you would prefer to just have a space like our workout community where we're all working and maybe we have music going, but for the most part, we're doing our own thing. So how do you feel this morning? Do you feel like you just needed a place for accountability to come and work? Or that's number one. Or number two, do you feel like you want me to actually run it like an action hour, talk, give ideas? You can still do your own thing, but maybe you learn a little bit along the way. Votes. All right. I see lots of twos. So,
and as a seasoned coach, I love just hearing ideas and like what's working for people.
Yeah.
As you go, you know?
Okay. So, cool.
And you know, you won't be quiet anyways, even if we chose one.
No, I wouldn't.
No, you wouldn't. So
you guys would have been doing me a disservice if you chose one. And I would have been like, I don't care. Listen to that.
I don't care. I'm talking anyway.
I got to tell you something. All right, let me grab a pen here. Awesome. Okay. So first of all, I want to say, however you're tracking your business, go ahead and make sure that you have that available. You guys, I am going to be the first person to tell you that you are not failing if you consistently change up the way you're tracking, because, the way you do something in your business isn't going to work forever. And in fact, if you get married to an idea of how you do something, you're going to lose excitement around it. You're going to lose momentum around it. You have to continuously change up what you're doing. So I actually track differently every day based on strictly how I'm feeling that day. So yesterday I tracked in a notebook and I tracked with, I had some notes up here. Hold on. Where am I at? This is, and I did the two different columns. It's super messy and the kids trampled it, but whatever, it doesn't matter. Invites on one side, connects on the other. So just general connections. And I don't write everyone I connect with, because if I'm being honest with you, I connect with a lot of people every day. It would drive me absolutely insane to write everyone down. But as humans, we're intuitive. We can tell people that we would automatically connect with. We can tell people we want to get to know more, that we're connecting with, that we want to move into an invite later. And those are the connects that I write down so that I remember to go back. And Shauna and I were just talking about this, 5-3-1 on their stuff, which that's, you know, like five of their photos, comment on three of them, message on one of them, get that conversation going. So you can do this. Some days this feels really motivating to me to track this way. Other ways I feel like I don't want this frickin' notebook by me. It's big and bulky and I just need to do what I need to do and focus. And I just grab the sheet that Allison Thornton shared with us a long time ago that has 100 boxes on it. And I just write down everybody I invite and connect on here. And I, if it's an invite, I put an I by it. If it's a connect, I don't put anything by it. And when people and I are in conversations, I highlight it and I do it all on one place. The trick is that you don't want to have things everywhere. Like, I need to keep these together, because when you're doing your follow-ups and when you're looking back at a time like right now, where we need to go back and do a blitz of all these people we've talked to for the past year that their answer was no, because they love the gym and this, that, and the other, you need to be able to find their names to be able to go to them and strictly say, listen, today, or I have, oh, wow. Thanks, pal.
Here you go, friend.
Thanks. And you need to be able to go back and say, like, I know that we talked like a few months ago. I just saw your name on a piece of paper because I wanted to remember to reach out to you. And now seems like the perfect time. I know you love the gym. I don't know if your gym is offering any sort of like online classes or anything like that. I know some are, but if not, I have 10 free workouts and 3 meal plans I'm sending to my clients, and I'd love to send them to you. I saw your name, so you were on my heart. Would you like me to send them your way? Right? So right now is a really great time where you get to go to all the people that said no to you, or all the people that were happy with what they were doing, and offer them a free solution. And I talked about this last night on Abby's call. You guys have a very unique situation in your hands right now that no one should be feeling negative about. I have never, you can ask Tabitha, yesterday I'm like, we're on fire. She's like, yes. What are we on fire with exactly? But like, I have never felt more excited about my business. I have never felt like we've had such an opportunity to shine with so many eyes that are really seriously watching us now and really seriously have the need for what we have to offer. So all of you with bad money relationships here, you've got to break up with that right now. You cannot assume that Rob's not going to buy Shakeology because he's not working right now because of the everything that's going on. You can't assume that Martha down the street, Martha doesn't want, that's an inside joke. I'm full of it. I'm on fire over here. You can't assume that Martha doesn't want to pay $99 for the year or to get the 3-day refresh or anything. You can't assume what people are going to want to do with their money. And I'm going to say this out loud right now, and Rob's probably going to chuck something at me from across the table, but right now, people are watching us more than ever. And I shared this on Abby's call, so I'm sorry if this is a repeat, but maybe it's a good thing to hear again. So your images and your excitement and your energy that you are pouring into the world right now is more impactful than ever before. And I felt like yesterday, I really needed to make sure that I wasn't just pulling the same sports bra and the same leggings off the top of my laundry basket every day and posting the same images. So I needed some new workout leggings. Rob's shaking his head over there. I needed some new workout leggings. Now, should we be spending a lot of money because we don't know, is our business going to take a little bit of a dip financially? Probably, but my favorite quote is the arrow has to be pulled back for it to launch forward. And I truly believe with every ounce of my heart that like this is going to launch forward majorly if you show up energetically right now in the way that you should with excitement. And so yesterday, for my social media imaging purposes, and that's what I'm putting on my taxes, see Rob, it all works out, I went and I bought 3 new pair of leggings. Now, I didn't go buy 3 new pair of leggings on Amazon where I know I'm going to be pulling them up and wondering if they're fitting good and wondering if my squat is squat proof or not. I went to where I love buying, which is Zaya. When girls squat, sometimes, like, if they don't have good leggings on, you can see through the leggings. Yep. As if he didn't know that. And then, so I went to Zaya. Now, anybody that knows Zaya knows that their leggings are anywhere from $60 to $80 each. And I bought 3. Whatever, you have a refrigerator sitting out on our front porch. But I bought 3. Why? Because 1, social media imaging. 2, because I know, like, and trust that. In this time where we're not sure, people find the money when they have the need for what is going to serve them. We have a major need for what is serving people right now, for what people need. You have to believe that. You have to not put your assumptions of money in anyone else's brain. You can't feel bad for inviting them when, if I could be completely honest with you right now, this community, this workout Zoom, these wine nights, these tagging Tabitha with Dear Diaries are saving my soul right now. I am happier, or just as happy as I was before this whole situation happened, because of the community that we have. And you have to believe that, and you have to show up in that way and share. So I want you to go ahead and grab your what do I want to say? Tracker. Grab whatever way you're going to track, your coffee, whatever you need, and we're going to jump in. Rob, you're going to need to exit the building if you're going to keep giving me looks.
I can't leave.
Oh, yeah. We're stuck. Okay. So the very first thing, and I'm just going to take you through what works for me. I truly believe that you don't need a place to work your business. I don't think you need a certain place that you work your business every day. Like, I can't sit at this desk every day and work my business because sometimes this place doesn't feel good to me. I do believe, though, that your brain loves routine and it knows how to mind. I was talking about mind hacks last night. You can set up brain hacks and mind hacks to get yourself into working mode. So there are many times that when I sit down to work, I'm not feeling in the mood to actually work at that time. But when I start doing the order that I always do things, I can trick myself into getting there. So I always do it in the same order, in the same way, every day. And that's what really helps me. So the very first thing that I do, because I think that it's also very important to start with something that makes you feel effective, makes you feel quick, makes you feel like you just like powered through something really quick and you were successful. The quicker you feel success in your work, the quicker you're going, or the more excited you're going to be. So some people jump right into invites. I'm going to be honest with you. I don't. I kind of do invites and connections at the same time. What makes me feel instantly kind of ready to work and like I quickly am there and ready to take action is I will make a post. So right before we got on here, I made a post. Okay. So I want you guys to all look at your last post. So mine is this beast mode, weird face post. And basically what I'm talking about in there is day 9 of quarantine. And I've got a serious question for you. Sorry, Owen, I'm going to swear. Are you feeling like a badass or nah? And then I go into, because you should be feeling this way. You should be taking care of yourself. You can have this, breathe in all that, you know, and I kind of give them some whatever. So what I do is I make a post at the very beginning of my power hour, of my action hour. The post can come from my personal development. It can come from how I'm feeling. It can come from a negative feeling I'm feeling, but a way I know I'm going to pull myself out. And then I'm going to use this for my action hour to maximize the people that I'm connecting with today. This is strategic. So I want you to take a look at your last post. And I want you to see, is it a pair of leggings or a certain sports bra? Or for me, my full tattoo is kind of showing. So look at something that you can get from this, or maybe it's the words, because we are going to go follow people from an account that when they look to see who we are, that we're following them, they instantly connect with the first picture they see on our page because we're strategically looking for the people that would connect with this. So for me, for instance, I would go to something like, maybe I'd go to, we're going to go to accounts here, not tags, not hashtags. So if I'm going to accounts, then if a lot of times if my full sleeve is showing, then I'll go to tattoo shops because a lot of people will come to my page. They'll see my first picture. They'll see I have a tattoo and they follow me back. Your goal is to get people to connect with you the minute they come on your page so they follow you back. So for instance, some that I do is I go to Mayday Tattoo because that's the company, or that's where I get my tattoo done. With this image, I may also go to, I'm talking in here about like taking a deep breath, acknowledging your feelings that don't serve you, breathing it out, releasing it. So there's a little bit of like woo-woo hippie talk going on in here. So another place that I'm following right now from is Healing Energy Tools. It is has 383,000 followers, and it's all like about the universe and trusting yourself and, you know, meditation and whatever. So those I'm going to choose based on the photo that I posted last, what I am going to attract people with, right? So for me, I'm going to do the energy healing one because that's just what I'm feeling. So I want you to find an account, go to that account. You're going to go to their followers and you're going to go ahead and follow 50 people right now as fast as you can. You don't need to go to their account. If it's a guy and you don't want to follow guys, don't follow guys. If it's someone that looks really awkward and you just don't think you'd have anything to talk to them about, we shouldn't judge a book by the cover. But if you don't feel like they would be somebody, go ahead and just don't follow them. But I go through and I actually follow 100 a day, 50 a day, and I unfollow 100 a day at the end of the night, and I'll show you how I do that, because I'm trying to get my following down right now, because you shouldn't be following more than like 1,000 people, ish. So go ahead and just take the next couple minutes and follow 50 people. as you guys are doing this, why don't you give some people some ideas that are on this call and throw up in the chat what type of account you're going from. It could be Nike Women's Nike account. Here's the thing though. You want it to be
overworked husbands.
You want it to be broad, that they have a large following, but you also want it to be specific so that when they come to your page, they see that you are like them. And a lot of people like women Nike. You know what I mean? Like, they're not going to see you in a Nike bra and be like, ooh, she must be my person. So just kind of think of it that way. Let's turn some music on and I'll give you guys about 2 minutes.
To follow 50 people?
Yeah, dude.
2 minutes.
Yeah. Robert?
Hey, you started this for a long time.
Yeah, I was just hanging out some little West Coast town. Found a bar out by the sand, so I made my way in. First thing that caught my eye, like nothing I ever seen. Summer Auburn hair, a California dream. Yeah, now she was shaking there. Some old Motown song, and I couldn't say anything. So I sang along. She was a heartache on the dance floor. This little West Coast town, I drop by every night. I feel the cold. I'm out of mystery.
All right, I'm done. So when you're done, put done in the comments. Actually, when you're done, for those of you that work primarily a lot on Facebook too, pop over to Facebook and go to your friend suggestions and look for 5 to 10 new people to add as friends on Facebook. I just look for people that I have a few mutual friends with, so it's not out of the blue. Make sure they're not a coach. Don't overthink it. Just add, if they add you back or not, doesn't matter. You're just handing out business cards right now. Okay?
I'm right here right now, humming this little song. If I could say a thing, I'd want you to know. You were a heartache on the dance floor, heartache on the dance floor. Yeah, you're moving through my mind, I got to know your name, I got to see you again. And if you're
all right, 1 more minute.
What do you need, Owen? We need you.
I'll be right back. I have to go wipe a butt.
In the home stretch of a hard time, took a hard left, but we're all right. Yeah, life sure can try to put love to it, but we built this right. So nothing's ever gonna matter.
know that when my bones are good, rest don't matter, that the pain could feel. Life's good shadow that it plays. Just you and I remain the same.
All right, I'm back. All right, so doesn't that feel good? Don't you feel like you just connected with people that are going to connect with you because of what you are putting out there on social media? You guys, if you use this technique, you will see. Amanda, that's funny. And that you will see that people will follow you because they are coming to your page to see if they connect with you. And if you're following them strategically, you make sure what you're posting and what you're talking about in your stories are going to relate to who you're following that day. You are going to increase know, like, and trustability and get people to follow you a lot more quicker than if you're just like, oh, I like Amazon. I like roses. I like take your water bottles, whatever it is. You know, so that's a really good tip there. With that, the next thing I do is I am social on social media. This is a huge part. This is a huge part a lot of people do not do, but I am. How many of you primarily work off of Instagram? Okay, so you have some Instagram, some Facebook, primarily Facebook. Okay, so for my people that work primarily on Instagram, I mean, I guess you could do this either way. It's going to be a little bit different for Facebook because you're not going to be able to connect with people that you're not friends with, really. So what you're going to do is you're going to be social on social media. So just really quickly, without thinking anything, I go through and 10 people that show up on my newsfeed, whether it's Facebook or Instagram, I just comment on their photo. And it's just something like, oh, that's an awesome drawing. Did you draw that? Attention, I want to be real for a minute. Someone's sick, praying for them, you know, like sending a prayer for them. Love this quote. I love your eyeshadow here. Whatever it is, I comment on 10 people that I'm following or 10 friends just quickly through the newsfeed. On Facebook, I do that and then I like 25 other pictures. It just makes me active on social media. Facebook says, Instagram says, she's active, she's social, this is what this is for, let's show her to more people, okay? On Instagram, I do the 10, and then I comment on 10 people's things, but then I also go to the account I just followed off of, because I just keep it cohesive, and I comment on 10 of the photos there. I'm not following them, I'm just commenting. A lot of times they'll see my comment, and if I'm being true and they connect with me when they check my page out, then they're gonna follow me back and I didn't even have to follow them first, right? But it's being that social piece on social media. So I'm gonna give you about 4 minutes, 5 minutes, and this is why you can't overthink it. I'm gonna go through and maybe hopefully the first 10 photos or whatever, I'm gonna make a comment on. I'm gonna go to the account I just followed at. I'm gonna look at their photos that they are posting, or I'm sorry, what do I wanna say? That might be wrong. Instead of going to their account, I go to hashtags of that account because people will hashtag that type of thing and I do the hashtag. So I don't want to comment on the people, on the energy account. I want to comment on the people that connect to that account. So anyway, 10 there, like 25 photos. Don't overthink it. Literally, it's business cards. It's just people, eyes, connection, Facebook, Instagram, pushing your stuff out. So, ready, go. Bob is really stuck over here on how leggings aren't squat proof. He needs to talk about it later. I'll explain. Cheaply made. So people. Yes, Rob. Yeah, girls wear underwear. You can see their underwear. We'll talk about it later.
that are more.
Rent a husband. Just kidding. Were we social on social media? Yes. Don't you kind of feel like even though we haven't sent out invites yet, you guys don't understand the power of connection in this business being what leads you to success? Because I will be the first coach to tell you that I never sit down and say, I need to get 10 invites out today. I need to get 5 invites out today. I need to get 20 invites out today. I need to spread my energy to the world, let people know they can join me and connect with as many people as possible. And in that, the invites come. And they're a different amount every day. Some days there's none and some days there's 40. It really just depends. But connection and being social on social media has always, and my energy putting out there and staying positive and being consistent has always been what's pushed my business forward. This is Owen, and he wants to show you that he's currently out of office.
Yeah, because I'm going to the beach.
He's going to the beach. Oh my gosh, he's in shorts. He's in shorts and a and a t-shirt and flip-flops. I think you look awesome. Yeah, you look great. His shorts are on backwards. It's okay, just go fix them. Oh man, that was cute. Okay, so the next thing now is that I am going to dive into connecting and inviting. Okay, so what I do is I try to do all of them in my connecting and inviting with people that are liking, commenting, and then also on the list of people that I wrote down yesterday in the last few days that I'm purposely connecting with because I feel like there's something there. Okay, so first I'm going to do stories and I'm going to do off of my posts. So I do invites and connects at the same time. That's why I like to either have this going where I can write if I'm connecting or inviting, or I like to have my go for no sheet where I can write everything in one place. That's what makes sense to me. Do what makes sense to you. But what the very first thing I do is I right now recenter myself because now it's a different type of work hustle. What you just did was fun, easy, mindless, connecting, social. Now you are talking to people. the way you type, the way you talk, the way you feel right now is coming through your posts. 100%. So usually at this time, if I'm being 100% honest, I reset my energy with pulling an affirmation card or something that's going to get my mind in the space to really be able to deliver, like, just be authentic and not worry about what's going on around me or what's already happened for the day. I use this in the morning. I'm sure if any of you follow my stories, you see multiple cards shown throughout the day, and it's just whenever I kind of need them, always in the morning, typically before or after my workout, and then during my work, and if I need a reset sometime later in the day. So for right now, I just pulled one and it says, the more I attune my energy with appreciation, the more the universe will deliver. And that's so perfect for us right now, because if we can attune our energy right now with appreciation as we connect and invite people, then the universe is going to deliver people that can honestly feel that. And the universe, God, say whatever it is that feels good to you. I am definitely 100% a Jesus lover and a Christian, but I know some people get weird about universe or whatever. I just use it interchangeably to what works for me. So the more I attune my energy with appreciation, the more the universe will deliver. So as you're connecting and as you're talking to people today and as you're inviting, really appreciate what we have to offer and know that you are offering a safe space and come with excitement. So the very first thing that we're going to do is we are going to go to our stories. I go to my stories. I go to the very last one. So the one that's about to expire, and I do this on Instagram first, and then I do the same thing on Facebook. I go through and I look at all the people. Wow. I look at all the people who have been following my story, and I go to the very bottom. The reason is because the people that show up at the top are the people that are always watching you the most. So I go to the bottom because typically those are going to be the people that you either followed yesterday or today that just saw you followed them, and they came to your story to see what you were about, to see if they want to follow you back or not. It's a way to instantly connect with those people. And all I do right now is my mind is set on I'm just connecting and getting to know people. However, invites will naturally come from this. So for instance, this girl, Abby, she follows me forever. I've invited her a long time ago. I haven't invited her for a long time, but she follows my stories every day. I know right now that I'm going to send her an invite to see if she wants the 10 free workouts. I'm leading with that right now with people with 10 rounds. And what I'm doing that's working right now for 10 rounds is I'm sprinkling it heavily in my stories and heavily on social media so that it feels more comfortable for me to invite to that, because it does feel more comfortable right now to invite with the free thing, but we still need to be talking about the other stuff, right? So in my head, I need to get clear now on what I'm inviting to. I'm offering the free solutions that we have to people that have said no. I'm offering the 10 rounds to people that are connecting with me about that stuff and people that I know did Core de Force with me or loved that type of workout. And then also anyone that I know that's a mom that loves wine and that maybe wants to be in the business, I'm inviting them to Tabitha and my wine night sneak peek on Friday night. So those are the three things I know what I'm inviting to. What are you inviting to? Be very clear about that right now, because now we're going to go through this and you are going to be writing down if you're connecting or whatever. If I'm connecting with people and like this Emily girl, I've never talked to her before. I click on her, make sure she's not a health and fitness coach, and I send her a message. And all it literally says, I have it in my text replacement, is it says, hey there. Let me see exactly what it says. Hold on. It says, when I put it in here, I'm actually not going to send her a message because she is a coach. It says right in her thing, but I just want to see. Hi, I hope you don't mind. Or hello, I hope you don't mind. I saw that you watched my stories today, so I just wanted to reach out and connect. What is it that you do? That's it. Remember forming, family, occupation, recreation, message. I just jumped past the family and I went straight to occupation. What is it that you do? She's going to tell me. She's going to ask me what I do. And I'm just nonchalantly going to be like, oh, I'm a virtual health and fitness coach, or whatever it feels good for me to answer in that moment. I'm not going to go into depth about it. That's not an invite for me to pour my business into her. I'm just answering like a bus stop answer like she just did for me. From there, I'm going to feel if I'm going to be like, I love the vibe of your page, or, oh, that's awesome that you do that. We're going to either connect and the conversation's going to move forward or it's not. After a few times of it going forward, there is no right or wrong way of when to send an invite. If you feel a connection right away, invite them right away. If you don't, and it takes a few times, that's fine. But remember, there's talking about family, occupation, recreation, and then you have to not be the creeper who keeps the conversation going, just waiting for the perfect time. You have to know that once you've crossed those three places, that you have to either invite them or shut down the message. Hey, it was really nice chatting with you. I loved getting to know you. Hope that you have a great Tuesday. Shut down the message. It doesn't mean they're not going to watch you anymore, but if you didn't feel that reason to connect or invite with them right then, it's okay to move on. However, if you want to invite them, then you have to jump on it right then. You have to realize there are people that if you see something in someone else, other people do too. And if you don't invite them, someone else is. And by the time you get around to doing it, they're already going to have joined someone else. So just be confident and don't wait for the perfect time. Use your intuition. You all have it. And let's go ahead and connect and invite off of our stories first. When you're done with your Instagram stories, I go through the story and connect with people and invite people off of any polls or anything I've done. And then I go to my last couple posts and look at people who have connected or commented or liked and connect and invite off that. So you guys have a lot of people probably that you can do this with, because I do it on Instagram and then I do it on Facebook. For me this morning, I'm just going to do Instagram. I'll do Facebook later. Sometimes I split it up because you have two totally different markets, but you can't ignore one. You have tons of people on both sides, different types of people. So you want to be able to connect with both. If you only work on one platform, then just focus on that. If you get done and we're not done yet, tell me, because then I'll have a tip for you on how to connect and move forward a little bit. At this time, you could also go through your old tracker sheets when you get through this and connect with people on asking them to join the 10 rounds. Another thing you could do is do a really awesome story about either the free workouts that you have to offer or 10 rounds that's going to be launching or the business that you're going to be inviting to. And after you do your story, I feel like I have full reign to invite any and everyone. Or after I do a post about it, any and everyone, assuming that they've seen it. What? Oh, just 1 second, okay? And I just say to them, hey, I don't know if you saw my post today about the wine night sneak peek that we have, or wine night coaching session we have coming up on Friday, but the more the merrier. We're looking for moms that need a little bit of relief from the quarantine, and you're invited. Are you interested? Or whatever. But when you put a post or a story out there, what do you need? Okay. When you put a post or a story out there, it's like it gives you more confidence to invite without that fear of what are these people going to think or whatever, because you can just assume we're friends on social media. Wow, look at that box. Dad, you should bring that box in so they can play in it. That'd be good, right? Okay, thanks. You can assume like, okay, they've seen it or they will see it, because if they didn't see it, then they'll read your message and they'll be like, what is she talking about? And then they'll go look. And now it all makes sense. So for me, if I'm having days, because I'm human, where I feel like the invites just aren't coming authentically, they're just not sitting right, I just don't feel that powerhouse like feeling of inviting, and it doesn't feel like I'm honoring like my true self, because I really need to find joy in the business all the time to be able to show up the way that I need to, then what I do is I think, I'm going to either do a really cool story right now about something that I'm excited about or a post about it, because the minute I do that, I feel 100% confident being like, hey, Brie, I don't know if you just saw the post that I did, but I know we talked about coaching a while back, and I know that you were just kind of waiting for the right time. I really think right now is the right time. Check out my post. Let me know if you're coming Friday night, right? It's easier to like use your own third-party tool. Right? Third-party tools are videos that we send to people to inform them about Shakeology, or things that make other, it's like a way to take the pressure off of us explaining and have them check something out. So you can create your own third-party tool that you direct people in and invite around. So right now, go ahead and do that. I'm going to give us 12 minutes to go through your stories, go through your posts, connect, invite, and then invite people from the past maybe that are popping up in your head. And then if you kind of get stuck there, create a really great post or story about what it is that you're really excited about that you have to offer right now, and make a plan in your planner for later today or when we get off this call, because I won't keep you guys too long, that you can go back for 20 minutes and invite using that as that third party tool. All right, here comes the music. Sorry, it's crazy over here. That's just life. Do we have any requests? Because I'm in a country feeling, but I know that not everybody loves country.
I got a request.
Rob doesn't count. If you have requests, go ahead and put it in the chat.
Aquarium rescue unit.
No. This is the... This isn't work music. I keep shushing him. He's gonna get mad.
About who you are.
look back on his past, but sure not half the man you think that you are. And you can feel the hole inside of you with money, girls, and cars. I'm so glad I never had a baby with you. You can't run nothing unless there's something there for you. Oh, I feel so sad.
Ooh, child, tired of the bullshit, mind that's a short one. thing. Yeah, Lord, trying to get some new shit in there when we're on the pool shit. I'm not gonna drag the line. I'm not gonna lie. I'm not gonna talk. I'm not gonna try. If you need advice, I'm not gonna lie.
No, it's gonna cut the music out every time you talk loud and then. All right, finish up on the one you're on now. All right. So go ahead and in the chat, I just want you to put how many invites and connects you just got done. Let's just see how we did here. I think it's important to kind of do that because some of you may not invite this way or connect this way, and you may find that you get more done in a shorter amount of time. Or you may find the opposite, that this didn't work for you and it's easier for you to sit down and just pound out 10 invites and sit down and pound out 20 connects. So for me, Tabitha got 27. Woo! Amanda, 12. Are these invites or both of them together? 31 invites. Jessica, Patrick's on fire. I got 15 invites. And 7 connects combo for free docs and boxing. Awesome. 25, 19, 31, 12, 27, 16, 8, and 2 for the wine and sneak peek. Yes, Bree, the only one I heard about coaching so far. 17, 14. Awesome. Okay, so what I want you to do right now, we're going to move on to the next thing, but just kind of take note where you left off. Like for me, I only got through my Instagram stories. So I need to go to my posts later. So I make a little note here. I need to do my IG posts and connect off of people. Make sure I'm commenting back to people who are commenting on me. You want people to engage with you. So you want to make sure that you're responding. So I need to check my IG posts later. And then I need to do a complete Facebook story and post, connect, and invite. Now, if you don't work the business, like if this isn't your full-time thing, you can just do one day and one the next day. For me, it's my full-time thing. So I do a couple power hours a day sometimes just to fit it all in and do everything that I need to do. So from here, I also want you to take note. Did you invite to the business today? How many of you invited to the business? Bree is the major winner. She's a brand new coach as of like 2 weeks ago. And look at her rocking it out. That's awesome. And Val, you invited to the business too? Hold on a second. Boys. Okay. All right. So what I want you to do is make another little note by where you left off, and I want you to commit to talking to someone or inviting someone to the business today. So for me, when I started, Christina told me that if I talk to one person about the business every single day, and I make that effort to just talk about it to one person, breadcrumb about it, invite at least one person a day, you're inviting 30 people throughout the month. Out of those 30, let's do the numbers. 15 are going to ask questions about it. 7 are going to actually listen to a sneak peek. 3 are maybe going to really be interested, and 1 or 2 are going to join you, right? Like, that's the number game. So if you can invite at least one a day or talk to at least one a day, it gets you in that habit and it gets you to enrolling a couple coaches a month. And I'm going to be honest with you, in the round table, boys, come on. In the round table, give him what he wants. Give the boy what he wants. In the round table the other day, they actually had a discussion where I think it was Kasha or somebody wrote that, can you guys go in the other room, please? I'm almost done, okay? Thank you. It was Chelsea Pearson. She wrote, what is the sweet spot for you with enrolling coaches and being able to truly help them on their journey? And you know that Ashley Malstead and Emily Favre, they get like 900 coaches, 700 coaches, 600 coaches a year. What is that even in a month, right? A lot of top coaches, tons of top coaches commented on this thread and said 3 to 4. Micah Folsom said like 5 to 7. The magic number doesn't need to be huge, but it has to be consistent and it has to be quality and it has to be your people and you have to be able to serve them. If you're trying to enroll too many, then you're not going to serve them, to keep them, to help them and do what you're wanting to do. Hi, Jersey girl. If you are just enrolling, if you're talking to 1 to 2 people about the business a day and you just make a promise to yourself for your business, for your future, for your family, that you can do that because you can, it's going to result in you getting a couple coaches a month. And a couple coaches a month is enough to bring you success because you're going to be able to handle it. And eventually you're going to get more comfortable and talk to maybe 4 to 5 people about coaching a day. And it's just going to go up. So I actually don't have a time where I sit down and I invite to coaching right then. I kind of see how the day goes because a lot of times I think those conversations come on naturally. But by the end of the night, if I haven't talked to a few people about coaching that day, then I take the conversation there. Okay, so that's just like a check in there. So the next thing I do after I do that is I go ahead and I've responded to likes and comments and views, and I've invited and connected with people. So then at this point, I'm gonna go ahead and follow up with people. So we're gonna go look at the people that we've invited in the last few days. A really great thing to do is, how many of you did the post where you did the free workouts and the meal plans, and you just sent them the free links? Right now, I hope you wrote their names down, because right now is the perfect time to message them and ask them if they've tried it and invite them into your challenge group. Invite them into your community, because right now you should be serving your challenge group and your community like you've never, ever served them before. Because you want people to stay. And they're going to stay where the energy is. They're going to stay where the positivity is. They're going to stay where the connection is. And if you're not serving them at a level that's out of this world right now, in this time where people want to be distracted from what's going on, then you're missing the ball. Okay, so more energy. And that doesn't need to be crazy. Like Jessica Willis, she dances and lip syncs like a magician. I don't even know. I couldn't think of a name. A magician, that's what came up. But in her group.
Or like a lunatic.
Maybe or like a lunatic, but it's like a magical lunatic. No, but with her, if she brought that energy in a live 1 minute video motivating her group every day in this time to stay positive and keep their mind focused on, maybe she does a card pull in there for me, like I would do a card pull in there, or what would it be for you? If you guys can think of a simple thing, it doesn't need to be taking a lot of time, but something that can make your, like the service that you have, make people realize that that's the place they want to focus and that's the place they want to be because that's what feels good right now, you have a major, major advantage to building such momentum in the next few months in your business. So right now I want you to follow up with all those people you sent the free kids workouts, the free workouts to, and ask them how they're doing it. And then say, I would love to get you in this free community. And then I want you to plan right now, what is a challenge that you're doing in your free community or in your challenge group this week, where you're going to take points and there's going to be prizes that people earn, and you're going to commit to sending prizes because that's going to get the energy up. It gives you something else to talk about. It gets more people that want to be in there. So let's set ourselves up for success. So for the next 6 minutes, and then we will go ahead and wrap it up live, and you guys can continue working on your own or break and go to your families, whatever you need to do. But right now, I want you to follow up with the people that you've sent things to. If you didn't do that, I want you to make the post. Plain and simple. Don't make it hard. I have 10 free workouts and meal plans to send to people, or whatever it is. Who wants it? Like, a lot of things people are like, I know that, I don't even know. My post is on my page. You can check it out. But other people did different examples. But make the post if you haven't yet. If you have, follow up. And follow up with the people that you've been inviting and talking to in the last few days. Don't be afraid to. And please, Jalene's asking for ideas in the challenge group if you guys want to post those in the chat. And then please, what do I want to say? I was going to say something. Follow up with those. Please, 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 if you need to hear this right now, get out of your head about following up with people. People are busy. They're distracted. They're not ignoring you because they don't like you. They're not ignoring you because they're not appreciative of what you offered. If you need to, close the conversation, but don't leave it open. Say, hey, I realized you haven't answered me in a few days, and this time is so crazy. I hope you're surviving day 9 of quarantine, and I'm sending you lots of love. Have a good day. Close the conversation. A lot of times it lightens the mood. It makes them want to talk to you. It brings them back. No, I meant to answer you. Things are just crazy. Or it connects you guys on something else. Remember, at the end of the day, people aren't going to join you right away all the time. They need to know you more, like you better, and trust you deeper. And when you connect and you close follow-ups and you act like just a normal human being that they can connect with and feel safe with, they're getting closer and closer to joining you each time. So with that being said, it's 11:11. Everyone make a wish and go ahead and do your follow-ups. We've got 4 minutes. And this is just a good song. I don't keep my phone this close to me when I work. I'm doing it because of the microphone, just so everyone knows. I'm not like.
Living life on the merry-go-round. You're broken down and tired. Living life on the merry-go-round. You can't find a fighter. I see it in you, so we gon' walk it out. Ooh, mountains. We gon' walk it out and move on day. And all eyes up, I'll rise like the day. The silence is quiet, and it feels like it's getting hard to breathe. And I know you feel like dying, but I promise we'll take the world. feet. Ooh. I'll dance beneath your feet. Ooh. I'll dance and I'll rise up. I'll rise like the day.
All right. So I hope you guys are feeling like you got some work done today. I think at this point you can continue working on your own if you want. For me, I typically only give my brain about an hour to an hour and a half of focus. And then I do step away from my work and I just make sure like, okay, at this time, I'm going to come back in for this amount of time. So right now, just kind of write down what else you feel like you want to do later so that when you sit down, you don't just sit down and scroll, you sit down with intention and you know what the most important thing is to do. So for me, I'm going to check my IG posts, my Facebook story and posts. And then I am also going to do my inbox. So I schedule a time where I'm in my inbox so that I'm not just popping in and out throughout the day. And I also need to go into my challenge group and cheer all of them on and announce some sort of fun challenge that we're going to be doing this week. And I even want to think of like a fun challenge to do with my team sometime this week. So these are just things that I'm writing down so that I know I can shut my brain off at this point. I can do whatever else I need to do. And when I come back, I will have that. Now, Jalene, I don't have any ideas for the challenge group. I do know that like some people are doing a virtual spirit week. For the schools, for the kids that aren't at the schools, and we're like sharing them with their classrooms. But I mean, we kind of already do that in our groups. I mean, there's like, I don't know. Maybe we can share, like start a thread in the United Coach collaboration and as people think of things, just kind of throw them in there. Maybe we could challenge them to get on the live workout Zoom with us every morning. And forever, whoever shows up, because the more they can feel in our community, the more they're going to want to be involved. So what if like you give a point system for how for everybody that, you know, for showing up, you get a certain amount of points or a certain amount of entries in a drawing and some two people get drawn and they get samples or a meal plan or something at the end of the week. I don't know. I feel like the more you can pull people into events and connection, the better. So with that being said, I hope this was helpful. I hope that you guys got something out of it and you got some work done. And we're going to take a boomerang now because that is the fun thing to do when you're done with a phone call. I don't know if you knew that. Did you know that, Rob? Did you know that boomerangs are the fun things to do when you're done with a phone call?